Falkenberg, the first gamer, couldn't quite take it. Well done by Neagle. Gives it to Travis Schiller. He's chased down from behind by Bryce Gibbs. Beautiful tackle from behind Bernie Marnie, and that is a quality tackle from a quality player. Riley Knight, former Eagle Junior, the boy from South Clare. He's a true centre-half forward. He'll kick the Crows inside, attacking 50 to the teeth of goal. And a strong mark in the hands there by the player in Davis. Leading goal kicker for the Crows last year. Ben Davis comes in. He kicks truly. He's got the opening goal of this contest for Adelaide.
He's not that good off the ground, but I'll back him in here.
So McAdam, 3 goals, 4 on the year. Kicks towards the goal face. It's not going to make the distance. Flying at the back. I think Big Strawn's taken it. And I reckon he's going to kick around the body for a goal, is he? He snaps truly and has kicked it. Well done by the Dogs' defence. Neagle with a hand pass. It came out in the direction of Stengel. He should snap this goal. He does. He'll run through the middle of X Convenience Oval, kick towards full forward, looking for Strawn. So Kieran Strawn from 40 out, directly in front, leans back on it and has kicked his second. McAdam takes it from the contest, kicks it towards the teeth of goal. Oh. And a good mark taken by Stengel. 20 metres out, 60 degree angle. Beautiful kick, keeps it low, keeps it straight. It's a goal to the Crows. Adelaide will go on the attack again. The ball comes inboard now to Pahulki. We know he's normally a good user of the footy. We'll go inside 50. Strong comes in from the side. He couldn't quite take it. Great crumbing Stengel. Drops the hips, gets out of the would-be tackler, gives it off to Riley Knight. The snap around the body, a classy finish. So Tyson Stengel, too far out to score, you would suspect. Goes inside 50, in too much space. Unopposed, McAdam plays on it. Must have been touched. He'll look to square it up. Well done by Jordan Neagle. Gibbs marks, plays on, off a step. Class from Gibbs, finishes off with a goal. As Butts for the Crows will take the kick out. Plays on, opens up some space, kicks to that outer side, halfback flank, and a good mark out there by Strawn. Adelaide now, quick ball movement from them. Knight gives it to Pahulki. He runs through the middle of X Convenience Oval. Payne chases from behind. Pahulki goes inside 50, Himmelberg. 30 out directly in front. I've marked it down already. He should kick it. Elliot Himmelberg for Adelaide does kick it. He and McKenzie raffled it with each other. McKenzie follows up. The snap kick of sorts came from Menzel. He gets it back on the boot. Kicks towards goal. He's dribbled it through. Well done by Jaden Neagle. Well done by Hoskin. In there to apply some pressure. Gets a spiral kick inside 50. Falkenberg. So Gibbs, again, racking up plenty of possessions. A dangerous kick across the board looking for Butts. Intercepted there by Gillard. The Dogs should win out now with some numbers. Travis Schiller marks in the goal square. Walters in and kicks his second.
I haven't seen Menzel work as hard as this.
He's played quite well as big man Hoskin takes a hanger. A highlight for the Dogs in the dying stages. Pahulki, he'll give it over the top. The running Jones off the non-preferred left. Beautifully checked the kick and found Big Jacobs. He's got McAdam inside 50, goes in that direction. Weaver gives him too much space. McAdam can give a handball over the top. Beautiful play from him. Gives it to Knight, dribbles it through. Answering goal to the Crows.
Kick toward Hender. Hender's got a man running into the square. It's Nixon. It's a dribbler. It'll be okay. Nixon, did he get a boot on it?
I reckon he did.
I reckon he's got it right on the tip of the boot. Spinning was Battersby. Away to Mark Evans, who started on the bench. Just a long kick. Hone takes a wonderful mark. Wants to play on. Does play on and rolls it through for a goal. Kick inside 50 is a good one. Mark taken by Ramsey, is it? The umpire hasn't paid it. And they all stopped. And Hender said, well, take that. Zekely boots it inside 50. Oh, that's a wonderfully weighted kick by Zekely. And an equally good mark from Maxi Thring. Winds up. That is a wonderful kick, Max Thring.
The ball just hung there for a long time and had to wait under it.
Oh, brilliantly done by Schwartz just to pickpocket it away. Oh. And goes long with a thumping kick for a goal. That's a ripper. Little handball back to Allman. Had Combe in the middle and then feeds it to Harvey. Harvey, well, away it goes to Hender. Now Hender's going to back himself here. I reckon he thinks he can kick this and he's going to do just that.
Mate, there's the old saying about make hay. I'm a big believer in that. While the sun shines, they've got to keep hitting the scoreboard here, North, while they're on top and Sturter completely rattled at the moment. They've lost their shape, lost their structure.
Faye Sparks. Battersby back to Faye Sparks to the runner in Slimming. Slimming another handball away. Petullo lining it up is Greenslade and threading it through. Well done by Troppiano. Gets a handball to Zekely. They might get a late one here. Here's Neagle's about to get run down. He is.
No, good chase. Good chase. The AFL's tried to get that leading with the head out of it, haven't they? But I think you're right. It's part of the game.
Here's Colquhoun. Just rows it off the pack and draws it back and kicks a goal. Here's Riley, just kicks to the hot spot. Big mark, almost taken. Is it paid?
On cue.
Back in the middle, away to Thring. North Adelaide will want to reply really quickly. Long kick. Oh, that right, is just...
signature, wasn't it?
That is Jack Stevens. So, lock a whack. A little bit of inexperience there.
We did have a player, just if he'd raise the eyes, he did have an option there.
Handball at the top by Greenslade. Here's Hone from 25 metres out, pumps it through. Quick kick out of there by Tropiano. It's a high ball, but all double blues here. Colquhoun's going to get it from Crocker. And then the little dribbling ball away to Battersby. Battersby just threw it on the boot. Oh, goodness me, he's kicked a goal. Out of the centre, Tropiano kicks forward. Good mark, Spina. Launched himself. Aiden Riley decides to switch to Edmonds, who ran to this side of the ground. Takes the mark and then keeps running. What's he got in front of him? He's got a long kick. And Hone just got out in front and took the mark. A little bit of Matthew Lloyd grass throwing from Hone. Hone's kick is a goal.
Works in nicely. Gaffney and big fly. Good grab there. Kane Stevens. He can do it all at ground level and in the air.
Enjoys getting out and about. Nature, big Jared. And his foot, charging toward an open goal. Nice disposal, holds it wide. It's 20 seconds for the Eagles to get the first goal of the second.
Tough unit, Jared. Kick high is taken by Duncan Hayes. Have you got any? Oh, he's going to turn it over, and he has. 40 out just from a couple of steps. Kick looks like it. It is a good one, and the Eagles getting some real momentum. They're third for the turn.
So we're going back in again, and Redden's all alone in the pocket. Wosley Black tried to upset him, but that was a big, strong mark from a 6-1 this season for Redden after kicking 7-3 last year. The tight angle won't bother him. He seals the deal. They've kicked 4 in a row.
Gilhouse in a good position and should have held on to that. Just dropped it forward. Almost was uncontested when he went up for that little giveaway. And the high kick just a blaze away. The handball was from Kirk. Great courage. That was absolutely fantastic.
I'll tell you what, as well, Soda, I'm watching John Casey get power up the stairs as well, and not just the voice of football, he's an athlete as well.
Here he comes right now. Let's get going to the second half. Petrenko trying to work his way through, gives it to James Rowe. 3 in a row for Rowe, and that one took 17 seconds.
Handball over the top. He's got the run here from Jack Gaffney. His kick is a good one as well for Goldsworth. He'll just open the door to Anderson, who did a great job. Kane Stevens did a good job as well. He went with his banana and came up with a much-needed goal for Westies. And eventually, Cooper Gaffney gets them up to inside their attacking 50. And how about the grab from Nick Hayes under pressure?
Notice it said Gilhouse. Remember last time, Hayes, a couple of weeks ago, worried he had the fake tan on for the game. Let's hope he didn't have it slip off there.
Very the
fake
slippery. Tan on the hands. I don't know if you know, Soda, but it is very slippery stuff on your hands.
Kick around the corner, though. It's a beautiful goal. Jackie Johansson. Here we go, trying to get around the corner. A little gift from Moore. And the steadier. Has it come around nice? I think it has. Have a look at that.
Of course, you'll see all the latest on 7 News regarding results from the games. And here's Jordan Foote driving the Eagles forward. Gilhouse knocked it down to the advantage of Petrenko. Dangerous in this situation. You'd back him from there. And Jared Petrenko gets his first. Once McJork caught behind was the defender. And heavy contact there between two Eagles players. And he's down and hurt at the moment. Goldsworthy bleeding from a cut near the eye. It's going to be an easy goal here for Haysman. He turns around and kicks it through. Early rounds of last season, but back-to-back for the first time since 2016. Turner gets a running shot at goal here, and West Adelaide get a late reply.
28 possessions coming up now for Jordan Foote. Pops it up the top of the square. Johansson has done well, the little man, against Aaron Wosley Black. 54 points just to take it out to a clean 10-goal lead, and we're well into time on. Johansson slaps it through. So have a look at that. The Eagles in a fantastic position now.
And ball came to in Port Adelaide's attacking 50 at the moment. Willem True measures the pass, wants Marshall, and coming out, it is in fact taken by Sam Hayes. So a good start for him. So first game of the season for Sam Hayes. Kicked 6 goals last year, and he's got the first here this afternoon inside 3 minutes with his career. So the Redlegs looking to go inside 50 for the first time. It's the danger man Bampton. Hands over now to the speed of Dom Barry, who from 55, intelligent kick to Wilson, didn't have to break stride, and the Redlegs have got the quick reply.
Kick looking for Zust. He's got to get around Pudney. Dangerous Zust kicked a couple of the former Panther against Port Adelaide in round 4. Cam Shenton puts it through. Great finish, great movement by the legs. Here we go. Bampton again just fires a handball out. There's a chance for Josh Richards. Oh, he's found the little speedster. Gonzalez in the square. Gives it to Johnson. And then which manufactures a kick on the outside of the foot. Didn't work, but here goes Sutcliffe. He gets around on his right foot. I think it's great.
So he's set a task for his defenders here. Brad McKenzie gets it to Shenton. He's going back across ground, left, fiddling around with it. He's over. Cooked it here, and Dixon's got it. Wrestles away from a would-be tackler. Going to put it on a silver plate for Frampton to march in and extend Port Adelaide lead. Just getting away from Norwood here at the moment. It's starting to open up. Sutcliffe, high ball. Ebert can't get to the contest, but Frampton can. And he's 11 goals for this season in the sample for Frampton. And he's got the accuracy here as well. So make it 12, and Port Adelaide extend the advantage now.
He just farms one out to Ollie Wines, goes with it, don't argue, and has another crack at it. Can't get through the second one. Gives it off. Interception was by Josh Richards. Going back, mark taken by Zust. Yeah, former Panther kicked 2 against Port Adelaide in round 4 at the parade, and that 34-point win from point blank slots it through. So Norwood will get there first for the second term.
So plenty of opportunities out there for the Redlegs.
Here's Wally Wines wheeling and dealing. Nice hands there. Gets it over to Sutcliffe for the finishing touches. Oh, that was pretty to watch from the Magpies. And off and running is Chris Olsen, going deep. Well-weighted kick. It was intelligent work to get it across to Brody Carroll. Now, Brody Dawes heading back to the goal square. Shenton running outside Brody Carroll, who elects to go solo. It's fading across the face, but bending back now, and the Redlegs get their second of the term.
Of Port Adelaide, Ebert shoots one out. Sutcliffe will improve that stat for Port Adelaide now as it goes forward. Dixon under enormous pressure. Off the deck was Tobin Cox, bouncing towards the goal, and the dive. Was it in time? I don't think it was. No, it's a goal with Tobin Cox.
Brad Ebert returning to the side after those concussion problems. Hasn't had a lot of time on ball. He's been a fair bit up forward and just getting the rhythm back of footy.
Goes to Attlee to Sutcliffe, going for his third on the outside of the right boot, and he's got it beautifully.
He wants Brady Dore, has been able to get enough of it today. The Redlegs lock it in. Zust, hand pass to Cole Girl. Off now, Dore for Louis Johnson. He's got too much swing on it to the top of the square. Ball in dispute. Wilson! Oh, he can create something out of nothing. And Anthony Wilson's done it again. Wants Attlee. Laddams at the back. Can he get there? Got a piece of it. Play on the call. Zach Richards pinned on the boundary line. Would take some sort of finish. He does the team thing. In a dangerous situation, Cody Zust. He's got Dom Barry in support. Open goal. The Redlegs are back to within one straight kick. It's game on.
Drew gets it, gives it to Ebert, held on, gets a handball out. Here's an opportunity for Attlee on the left foot, a squaring kick, mark is taken, and it's Boyd Woodcock, the former Rooster. South Australian under 18 representative last year in the national championships, grew in stature through the sample final series for the Roosters, played in a flag and slots through his first goal of the day for the Pies. Frampton using the body there. Here's a chance for Brady, but that was cut off nicely. But there's another chance on the goal, and it is kicked. It's Will and Drew.
Zust wrestled to the ground there, and a strong tackle by Hayes. Ball spills out for the Redlegs, and that looks like it is the first goal of the final quarter. It is. Zach Richards has done the job here, and it's taken just 30 seconds.
Port Adelaide, little chipping kick over the top of Woodcock. Frampton, here comes Ollie Wines, screws it around, and Ollie gets the goal.
Tries looking for Dixon, front position against Talia. Here's Shenton about to be run down. Did well to get the kick away, and it was a good one to Balderstone, who's got runners inside him. Dom Barry wants Cody Zust. Got to use a friendly bounce as well. He wants to go deep. Bampton been quiet today. Good position, and finally grabs the mark. 3 goals against Port, back in round 4, and he seals the deal there. The Redlegs get back to within 2 goals.
taking five marks and drops it into Ollie Wines. Quickly gets around on the right. Charlie, big, strong and powerful, the unit. Have a look at him. Seven marks to big Charlie. He's kicked two behinds. And he's got two goals to go with him.
He's ready to wheel around and go now. Out comes Dixon on the charge and lead and takes the mark. He's going to put some icing on the cake here, big Charlie.
This will come out for disposal. Number 12. Eight marks. Hopefully kicks his third.
Five goals, two last week for big Charlie Dixon. And from right in front. Just shading across, but it holds the line good enough. He's kicked three goals, two today, and the margin is out to 42 points.
Picked up here now by Carpenter. Kicked towards 50. Inside 50, a good mark back there, though, by Curran. The two number fives. The Partington now too far out to score. As we've said, got lots of tall timber to aim at. There's one nearly taken. Yes, it's been paid. I thought he had a good piece of it too, and it's Luke Reynolds down there. He is a pinpoint kick usually. This is on its way, and this is certainly another example of that. He's got one, the Tigers have got two. Brown with a hand pass looking for Little. The Tigers are swarming here. They're back inside 50. And again, the Panthers need to repel. Partington with a little rugby-style hand pass to Liam McBean. Well, I've never seen something like that. The big man has kicked the goal. Bills out now to Partington. Sweeping hand pass off one step to Motlop in game 100. He's nailed it. As Carpini has a chance to fire the first goal for the Panthers, and he sprayed it across the face of goal, but the mark's been taken by Beamans, falling over. He's sure to run around, Anthony Beamans, and his kick has nailed it. They're being questioned, they have the answers. Gregson took on the man on the mark, fires it deep inside 50. Scott sets himself. He didn't have to be jumping Josh Scott, but he was juggling Josh Scott. Summerton on the mark. Scott to the Onkaparinga end, and he has drilled it. He's got two. Out the back, the Tigers stand tall in the former Chalmers, but picked off by Beamans, the goal scorer already. Spun around on a dime, lines him up, and he's got two. Play on, says the umpire. Gregson got it out the back here to Bailey. Bailey now kick inside 50, picked up by McBean. McBean lines him up from can't-miss territory, and he slams it through. He's got two. Charging through is Carpini. Comes out the back here to Sampson eventually. Little hand pass. He was looking for Bogle but didn't find him. Panthers, though, applying the pressure. It comes to Emery, who runs to 45. And Kyle Emery. Crab goes short to Noble. Noble went short by Andrew Davis. Put him under all sorts of pressure. Has to go and help him out. Little chip kick over the top was clever by Noble to Schwartz. Schwartz now releases Brown. Brown over the top. They got him on the overlap here, South Adelaide. Overall's got a free man up forward in the former Whittlesey. Whittlesey turns around from 51 metres. Fires it in to his free man in form of Emery. He can run in and kick goal number two. Bailey was there. He was up to the task. But again, the Panthers come out of it. Here's Little now with a kick inside 50. But well done by Maxi Proud. Mark or free kick. Take your pick. McGree went early. Got the tap down. Snoop looking for it. Hands and knees. Somehow extricated it and got it out to Partington. He just blasted it to about 30 out. Big flight at the back there. Mark wasn't quite taken.
It
is Mark.
Yeah.
And this can make it three. Kicks on its way, straight as an arrow. Working his way to the front was McGree for the Panthers. Kick was smothered, but running onto it. Well, that's a great goal. Carpenter came from nowhere. Got a hand pass nearly towards half forward, but Bradley running onto it, dispossessed in the tackle. Advantage taken now here by Davis. Davis on the end of it. It's a beautiful kick to Emery. University Stadium here, twirling the ball in hand. A nice approach. A nice kick, a lovely kick. He's got three. We'll take the free kick and send Glenelg forward.
South Adelaide faithful not happy, Don?
Certainly not. I think we got the message from them then as he kicks to the top of the goal square. Big pack flies out the back. It comes from Reynolds. Reynolds kick around the body and he's got it. Favors cross. Heard a little voice in the former Bogle. It was met high by Scharenberg and the umpires all over that one.
Oh,
and Elliot
Chalmers just threw it straight back in his gob, said, here you go. So he managed to escape the wrath of the umpire there as Bogle bangs it forward to the top of the goal square. Big fly! Up over the top, Sammy Overall. Well, he's recovered all right. Sam Overall can have a great moment here. He can give South Adelaide back the lead. And he does. No quarter asked, no quarter given. Scharenberg's kick, a bouncing ball for McBean. Managed to get down well, got it to Bailey. Bailey into open space. It's a foot race now. Leading it there in the race is Scott. Scott did well, got it out the back to Reynolds. Reynolds has time to steady. Line up the goals. Oh, I tell you what, did he have time to line them up, and he's drilled it.
Could have been a shot on goal, but they just pushed him as he released the footies, and the ball went across the face.
Brad Close with a nice mark, putting those long-sleeved arms up, taking a good grab. Sends it inside, 50, and there's another good grab on the end of that's Reynolds. Can he kick 101 from 49 metres?
He likes
Kicks
it.
On its way. He really likes it, and why wouldn't he? He's got five. Picked up by Lonergan for the Panthers and gave it to Brown. Close in hot pursuit. Didn't get close enough, though. Back to Rose. Rose with a little kick over the top. Oh, it sat beautifully for Brown. Didn't have to break stride. Half forward. It's a brilliant kick if it sits. Oh, it was cleverly done. On the end of this is Joel Cross. Runs to 25 and kicks the goal. Listen to the crowd roar. And Crab to Noble. The Panthers are out through. He slipped to Davis. Davis now decides to go bang. 50-50s everywhere, crashing the pack there was Beamans. Umpire just letting it go. They put the Acme Thunder away as Carpenter's got Cross. Cross can turn and burn. He lines up. He loads up. He needs a kind bounce. It sits four and finds his teammate charging through the old firm. They've had a draw against the Panthers. Maybe they can take the points away from them here today on their home deck, South Adelaide. Picked up by McBean, runs into an open goal. Well, they've been asked the question, and there's your answer. The Tigers are back thanks to Liam McBean, and he's got three. Scott's got to bang it back in. He does. Here's McBean, leaps for it. What a grab. That is a match-saving mark from Joey Haynes. I tell you what. He's going to be the Lord Mayor of South Adelaide tonight, Joe Haynes.
What a mark.
In the dying seconds of a contest of an absolute thriller. Big fly, ball comes down. There's the siren. South Adelaide, they hang on.